Income of Slovaks is very simply 860 euros in brutto. That means in netto, if you pay the money for health care, money for retired time and sickness, else, then you are by 730 euros, and from this you can't buy a house for 2 million euros, of course. This is the average income. In Bratislava should be the average income higher, and it is 1,000 euros, but it's caused because the government, because the refinery, because many companies and banks and insurances. So by statistic, it tell you 1,000 euros, but really a sales assistant in the shop, she can also only 600, 700 euros monthly. So we are now going down to the castle to visit it. What's very important is to tell you a little bit about the education of Slovakia. It's free. Also, the education on universities is free in Slovakia. So, for example, here you see again the elementary school. Our children, they jump into the school education system in the age of 3 years. That means the kindergarten, first 3 years. And in the age between 6, latest 7 years old, that's decision of the parents, they start the elementary school, which is 9 years long. In the first class, we start to learn the children English language, of course, like a small game. In the third class, we start the German language. So the children, they have two languages, 9 years long, German and English one. And on the high school, which is mostly 4 years long, you get, or the child get gets the next language, which can be, and it depends from the school, Russian, Spanish, Italian, French, and other languages. Yes, so these are the possibilities on the schools. Of course, if you have the exam after the end of the high school, at that you can start to visit the universities, which means 4 up to 6 years long. It depends on which faculty you are studying. In Slovakia, we have 33 universities. Statistics tell us that every third baby is a university baby, and 17 are private. So by the private universities, of course, you need to pay monthly basis, but state universities are free. Government wanted to bring any payment for the universities, but they never do it before election, and we have election next year. So 1 year, of course, you can be sure that no payment on universities. They started it to do, but the students were having a big demonstrations, and so they stopped also the payment of universities. Ladies and gentlemen, now we are very close to the castle of Bratislava. So we are going now for a few minutes out of the castle, for example, for half an hour, to visit the nice view to the old town, to the River Danube. So I kindly ask you to come out of the bus. In few minutes we stop by the castle, in front of the castle, and we are going like a big family to visit the castle. So my white box is on. I hope that also yours. We can do at first a test if everything is working. If not, I have in my red bag also some few.
From my grandma, like the first one should feel good, also the last one. So we belong all together. So I wait a little bit. In the 90s, was very modern this time, as you can see. In front of us, we have one chamber, 150 deputies are working in the government seat, and at the moment is left oriented for the party, but it's only one chamber in the way. The city of Vienna. Vienna is only 50 kilometers away from Bratislava, by the way. And in the left hand, thank you. you need to use, or you need to have 5 hours for the castle. Inside of the castle, the big window, which is also the
Thank you. Now, this is a pretty tree here at Bratislava Castle. These are windmills in Austria. And this is Bratislava.
Before 41 now, so ladies and gentlemen, we are going now down to the old town. In the old town I do a walking about half an hour, not more. It will be very quick but very easy also for walking. We have a nice pedestrian zone which is very nice also for non-walkers. But in that case that you decide not to enjoy me in the old town, then bus is going directly back to the boat. Yes, so it's also possible to do that. But really the most beautiful part is waiting now at the moment for us, and that's the old town. That's what I like, what I love in Bratislava. It's a lovely pedestrian zone where it's possibility to walk for thousands of hours. If you want to visit Bratislava, only because the old town, only to walk it across the old town, it has only area of 9.6 square kilometers. You can do it in 20 minutes, but to visit 30 galleries and museums, 200 shops and 180 coffee houses and restaurants, you need minimum three weeks. Yes, so it's really, it takes a long time. But at first we have the walking, and then at the end you have free time, and where we end it's only 5 minutes away from your boat, so it's really very easy. I will show you. To the left hand side you see the European Information Center, so the flags of the European Union. 2005 we were asked also if we are interested for European Union by a referendum. 72% were for the European Union. So 2006 we entered European Union, 2008, since this year we have the official currency only Euro, Bratislava. Of course it's true that the prices were getting higher, especially of food, but the income wasn't getting higher, yes, so it's a lovely joke. That times in communism it was so that we haven't any goods but so much money. Today the joke is that we have so much good and no money. That's the difference between communism and today. Of course, to speak about communism, it's really, it needs a time. I like Czechoslovakian movies because they show you how it was. Today we can smile on it, but that times it wasn't for smiling. Everything was grey, like the buildings, so also the atmosphere of the city. And you needed to be very, very, it was very difficult time because, for example, I get from my grandparents the Grimm Brother book of fairy tales in German, under the Christmas tree. I was reading it in our garden, and our neighbor was a Russian soldier, and he was looking what we are doing every day. And one day my dad was one night in prison, and the government was asking him if we are not spoils of Western, because the small fairy tale book, yes, so it was really a dangerous time. If you entered churches, because we are today 80% Roman Catholic, that times we were 90%, so they wanted to close the churches, but in Slovakia it wasn't possible. And that times if you practiced the Catholic life, you were entering the churches on Sunday, etc. Then you didn't get a good job, or maybe your children didn't get any possibility to visit universities. Yes? So that was also this great time of communism. So really It's silly to open a bottle of plum brandy and to forget everything what was in that times, and to look in the future. And the future of us is the future of our children. So I hope that that what you will see today in Bratislava will be nice for you, and that you will see, help my eyes, city Bratislava like we feel. To the right hand side, you can see the view up to the castle. These modern buildings were built on the green square. At times it was a nice large garden. Today it is filled with offices, like you can see the presidential seat behind us, yes. And in front of us is waiting for us that old town, so the pedestrian zone. But mostly then we have problems from the bridges. We need to open them and to put it away because they are too heavy if they are too much for old bridges. Attention, ladies. Under this barbican house is a legend that I tell you before we are going under. If you start to speak under this barbican house, you get baby. One baby here, please. You can trust me, you must not trust me, but this is the legend of the city. This is the legend of the barbican house of Bratislava. And you see that we are going so in interesting form down to the old town. This, you can see the street, it was so built because this street, the barbican house, the drawbridge, water moat, should protect the main gate into the Middle Ages city, the Michael Gate. Michael Gate inside is beautifully reconstructed. Inside we have also the city museum, which is explaining you the history of the weapons, of the Middle Ages city, how we fortified the city, how we protected it. And the first two floors, the first two windows, like you can see, they are in the same level like the houses. So high where the city was. Then after the balcony, we built it in Renaissance, and at last we built the onion-shaped roof on top. Michael Gate today is the last gate that we have. All other gates we pulled down in the 18th century. That times we had four gates. So if you see our sign, here is Michael Gate, by the river Danube was Fisher Gate, Lorenz and Vikings. These three we pull down, and the last one is the Michael Gate. Here behind the left you see the smallest house of the city. It's numbered because it's closed, it's waiting for the reconstruction. It's 1.6 meters wide. Why is it so small? Because by the lamp was the smaller wall than by the Michael Gate, the big one. And the place was called in German Swinger, like you see the kebab. That was the place for the movement of the soldiers. They protected the city. Like we pulled down the walls, here was house, there was house, and the place was for the smallest house of the city. So here it's looking very small, but inside it's
like the house. So it's bigger inside.
Under the microwave, you'll find this gold ring. On the ring are names and kilometers of the cities. So this is the zero point here, and from the zero point you can count the kilometers to the cities they are on the ring. For example, Prague, 290 kilometers.
Lima.
Lima, yes, but I'm looking for, mostly are you from USA?
Yes.
Yes, so which city?
New York.
New York. 6,856 kilometers by air. Yes, so this is the distance. Or Vienna. In the Martinsk Cathedral, the king spent 5 hours by the coronation. He got the
crown of King Stefan on his head, and sitting on a horse, the beautiful swan, 30 kilogram big heavy dresses of Maria Teresa, pregnant sitting on horse, she was the name of the Michael Gate. Because in Middle Ages, behind the gate was an old church, Michael Church. This was destroyed by the Turks, damaged by the Turks. And so